Grace of Monaco, the style icon, and now Grace of Monaco, the film.
Some of you ask, why did I leave Hollywood?
Nicole Kidman plays the role of the most glamorous of princesses and actresses ever in this new Olivier Dahan film. The plot centers on the history of Monaco at a time when France was attempting to annex the principality, while Grace was being called back to Hollywood by Alfred Hitchcock to film Marnie.
I miss it. I can be a mother and a wife and hold down two jobs without the people getting too upset, can't I?
Here she is shown torn between the acting career she dreams of resuming and her role as a princess who must fight for her country alongside her husband.
I don't know, it's always politics with him.
Mr. President.
While the film offers a slice of Monaco's history and focuses on Grace's burgeoning romance with Prince Rainier, it also showcases the fabulous jewelry sported by this Hollywood actress who later became a princess. As a devoted client, Grace Kelly, later Princess Grace of Monaco, maintained a loyal relationship with a certain jeweler in Paris and Monaco. The filming of the movie naturally called for Cartier's expertise and savoir-faire. Cartier created the 10.47-carat emerald-cut diamond engagement ring, which the princess was given by Prince Rainier in 1956. For her wedding, she received numerous gifts of Cartier jewelry, such as a diamond and ruby tiara and necklace composed of three strands of diamonds. Faithful reproductions of five of these royal jewelry pieces were produced in Cartier's workshops. The original creations are part of the Royal Jewels of Monaco. In addition, Cartier was entrusted with the creation of a number of contemporary fine jewelry pieces worn by Nicole Kidman throughout the movie, as well as a spectacular emerald necklace seen on Spanish actress Paz Vega, who plays Maria Callas in the film. Cartier watches and accessories are worn by the male leads, Prince Rainier III, embodied by Tim Roth, and Aristotle Onassis, played by Robert Lindsay. Although a screening of the film will open the Cannes Film Festival on May the 14th, it is nonetheless being shunned by Monaco's royal family. The screenplay for the film was completely rejected by Prince Albert and his sisters Caroline and Stephanie, who disagree with the facts described therein. The royal family also requested many modifications to the script. A statement was released in January, indicating that the movie contains two significant historical inaccuracies, as well as a number of purely fictional scenes.
Mommy, why are you crying?
It would seem, therefore, that Grace of Monaco is a film that can be admired as an aesthetically appealing work of fiction, if only for the beauty of the Cartier jewelry featured throughout.
And you need to do it alone.